Good morning, children. Today I am going to explain lesson number 13, lies in different parts of India. So now India is a secular country. It is a unity in diversity, the main characteristics of India. So there is a different language, different lifestyle, different food, different type of climate, physical futures. There is all different, but we are all one, you know. So we learn in previous class, what are the types of different physical features of India? So the Indian physical feature is divided into 5 types: northern mountains, northern plains, desert land, plateau region, coastal region, and islands. So today in this lesson we learn the what are the lifestyle of these parts of India, these regions. So first one is life in the northern mountain region. What is the first part? Life in northern mountainous region. So now you know, in north side of India there is a large mountain ranges, that is Himalaya. So the long and high ranges of mountains lie in the north and northeastern parts of India. These ranges are called Himalayas, that is house of snow. They stretch from Jammu Kashmir to Arunachal Pradesh, covering a distance of 2,600 kilometers. States like Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, parts of West Bengal, etc. also lie in the Himalayas. The Himalayas have some of the highest peak in the world, like Mount Everest and Kanchenjunga. They are being bodies of slow moving ice called glaciers. In the Himalaya, rivers like Ganga, Yamuna and Brahmaputra originate in the Himalayas and get water from these glaciers when snow melts in summer. Himalayas guard the northern borders of our country by forming a natural wall between India and its neighboring countries. These mountains act like a shield against the ice winds that blow from the north. They stop the monsoon winds. It is because of its many places northern India receive rainfall. There are hills in central and north southern India too. You can see the eastern and western Ghats, Aravali Hills and the Nilgiri Hills marked on the map. So now let us know about the climate of India. So what do you understand about Himalayan mountains? So nimige gottu Bharatada north alli north inda northeastern part varigu saha navu en nortave high mountain ranges anna nortave alva. ಸೊ ಅದನ್ನೇನಂತ ಕರೀತಾರೆ ಹಿಮಾಲಯಾಸ್ ಅಂತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಅದು ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಹೌಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ನೋ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕವರ್ಡ್ ವಿತ್ ಸ್ನೋ. ಸೊ ಜಮ್ಮು ಕಾಶ್ಮೀರದಿಂದ ಹಿಡಿದು ಅರುಣಾಚಲ್ ಪ್ರದೇಶವರೆಗೂ ಕವರಿಂಗ್ ಎಷ್ಟು ಡಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಅಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ಅಂದರೆ 2,600 ಕಿಲೋಮೀಟರ್. ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಹಿಮಾಚಲ್ ಪ್ರದೇಶ್, ಉತ್ತರಾಖಂಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವೆಸ್ಟ್ ಬೆಂಗಾಲ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ಕವರ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಲೈ ಇನ್ ದ ಹಿಮಾಲಯಸ್. ಇವೆಲ್ಲ ಎಲ್ಲಿದೆ? ಹಿಮಾಲಯದ ಹತ್ರನೇ ಇದೆ. ಸೊ ಹಿಮಾಲಯ ಸಮ್ ಹೈಯೆಸ್ಟ್ ಪೀಕ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್. ಭಾರತ ಇಡೀ ಪ್ರಪಂಚದಲ್ಲಿ ಅತ್ಯಂತ ಎತ್ತರವಾದಂಥ ಪೀಕ್ಸನ್ನು ಶಿಖರಗಳನ್ನು ನೋಡ್ತೇವೆ. ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟು ಮೌಂಟ್ ಎವರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕಾಂಚನಜುಂಗ. ಸೊ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಮಧ್ಯದಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ನೋ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ಐಸನ್ನು ನೋಡ್ತೇವೆ. ಸೊ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ಐಸಸ್ನ ಏನಂತ ಕರೀತಾರೆ? ಸ್ಲೋ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ಐಸಸ್ನ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಗ್ಲ್ಯಾಷಿಯರ್ಸ್. ಇನ್ ಹಿಮಾಲಯದಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡ್ಬೋದು. ಅದಲ್ಲದೆ ಗಂಗಾ, ಯಮುನಾ, ಬ್ರಹ್ಮಪುತ್ರ ದೇ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಒರಿಜಿನೇಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಹಿಮಾಲಯಸ್. ಹಿಮಾಲಯದಲ್ಲಿ ಹುಟ್ಟುವಂತಹ ನದಿಗಳು. ದೇ ಗೆಟ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದೀಸ್ ಗ್ಲೇಷಿಯರ್ಸ್. ಇವು ಅಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಏನು ಪಡೆಯುತ್ತೆ? ವಾಟರನ್ನು, ಅಲ್ಲಿಂದ ನೀರನ್ನು. ಹಿಮಾಲಯ ಗೆಟ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದೀಸ್ ಗ್ಲೇಷಿಯರ್ಸ್ ವೆನ್ ದ ಸ್ನೋ ಮೆಲ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಸಮ್ಮರ್. ಸಮ್ಮರಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ? ಸ್ನೋ ಮೆಲ್ಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಹಿಮಾಲಯದ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಏನು ಅಂದರೆ, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಗಾಡ್ಸ್ ದ ನಾರ್ತ್ ಇನ್ ನಾರ್ದನ್ ಬೌಂಡ್ರೀಸ್. ಗಾರ್ಡ್ ನಮ್ಮ ದೇಶಕ್ಕೆ ಗಾರ್ಡ್ ಆಗಿ ನಿಂತಿದೆ. ಅದು ಕೋಟೆ ಅಂತಿದೆ. ನ್ಯಾಚುರಲ್ ವಾಲ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ. ಇಂಡಿಯಾಗೆ ಒಂದು ಪ್ರಕೃತಿ ದತ್ತವಾಗಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಒಂದು ಗೋಡೆ ಅಂತಲೂ ಹೇಳ್ಬೋದು. ನೈಬರಿಂಗ್ ಕಂಟ್ರೀಸು ಈಸಿಯಾಗಿ ಒಂದು ಗೋಡೆಯನ್ನು ದಾಟಿ ಬರಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಆಗಲ್ಲ. ಆ ರೀತಿ ಹಿಮಾಲಯ ಗಾಡ್ ದ ನಾರ್ದನ್ ಬೌಂಡ್ರೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಕಂಟ್ರಿ. ದೀಸ್ ಮೌಂಟೇನ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಟ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಎ ಶೀಲ್ಡ್ ಥರ ಇದೆ ಐಸ್ ವಿಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಬ್ಲೋ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ನಾರ್ತ್. ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಐಸ್ ವಿಂಡ್ಸ್ ಬರುವುದನ್ನು ಇದು ತಡೆಗಟ್ಟತ್ತೆ. ನಂತರ ಇದು ಸ್ಟಾಪ್ ದ ಮಾನ್ಸೂನ್ ವಿಂಡ್ಸ್. ಇಟ್ ಬೈ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದೇ ಪ್ಲೇಸಸ್ ಆಫ್ ನಾರ್ದನ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ರಿಸೀವ್ ದ ರೈನ್ಫಾಲ್. ಸೊ ದೇರ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಹಿಲ್ ಇನ್ ಸೆಂಟ್ರಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸದರ್ನ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಟು. ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ಈಸ್ಟರ್ನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವೆಸ್ಟರ್ನ್ ಗಾಟ್ಸ್. ಈಸ್ಟರ್ನ್ ಮತ್ತು ಸೆಂಟ್ರಲ್ ಮತ್ತು ಸದರ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಈಸ್ಟರ್ನ್ ಮತ್ತು ವೆಸ್ಟರ್ನ್ ಗಾಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ನೋಡ್ತೇವೆ. ದೇ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಡ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಮ್ಯಾಪ್. Next, you learn about climate in the mountain. What type of climate in mountain region? The summer month of May and June are not really hot in the mountains. In fact, some mountain remains covered with snow even in summer. In other places, the weather becomes pleasant. People come from the plains to spend their summer vacation here. And also, the monsoon causes heavy rainfall in the foothills of Himalaya. The heavy rain sometimes result in the many rivers flooding the plains below. Monsoon winds blow from the Arabian Sea around the month of July. The first few showers are experienced along the eastern and western ghats. Chirapunji in Meghalaya received the highest mountain of rainfall in the world. Next, winter month, that is November to February. It is very cold in the mountain. In the higher the reaches the most mountainous, there is a heavy snowfall. So that is the climatic condition in summer and winter. Next, you learn about the lifestyle of people living in the mountain. How did the people live in here? What is the main occupation of the people in mountain region? The main occupation of the people living in the mountain is farming. Terrace or step farming is done the slope of hill to grow rice, maize, tea depending on the height of the region they are living. Orchards are the fruit like apple, peaches, pears, palms, etc. are common here. People also rear the animals like sheep and cow for wool and milk. Fruit, wool and handicrafts are the sent all over the country from these regions. On the Dal Lake in Kashmir, many people make their living by using the boats called shikars to give rides to the tourist. Here, handicrafts are also a source of income. Shawls and walnut furniture, paper mache articles are all some famous handicraft of Kashmir. In the eastern state, most of the people belong to different tribes like Garos, Khasis, etc. They hunt and cultivate the land and catch the fish for living. Cane and bamboo handicrafts are famous in the some eastern states like Assam, Nagaland, etc. Houses in the mountains usually are sloping roofs to prevent the rainwater and snow from the collecting. Some houses are made up of wood and some common buildings materials like cement, bricks, stones, etc. Cloth people wear. What type of cloth they wear? Already you learn of before. What type of cloth they wear? The people of Kashmir wear the typical long woolen shirt called firan with salwar. The men cover their heads with caps and women wear dupattas. In Himachal Pradesh, women wear the kurtas and churidars with scarves tied their heads. When wear the kurta tied at the waist with the band and chedars, they wear the famous and colorful Himachal caps on their heads. In most states in northeastern India, people who belong to different tribes wear the traditional dresses of their tribe and follow their own customs. So next you learn about the sources of river. Himalaya are the source of all great rivers of North India. In summer, snow on the Himalaya melts and provide the water to these rivers throughout the year. The water of these rivers is used for irrigation and for producing the electricity. The rivers also bring new fertile soil with them, deposit it in the plains and make them fertile. Hill stations. All the beautiful hill stations in northern India like Srinagar, Pahalgam, Gulmarg, Simla, Kulu, Manali, Dharmasthala, Dharmashala, Dehradun, Nainital, look, they are important hill stations in Himalaya. Thousands of visitors came to these hill stations. So next we learn about the agriculture and herbs. Many useful herbs which are used for medicine grown on the slope of Himalaya. They also grown the Himalayan slope. India is a big producer of tree. Agriculture. The slope of the mountain have been terraced and produced the rice, maize and potato vegetables and fruits. Tea plantation are extremely developed on the lower of the, especially in eastern Himalaya. Storehouses of minerals. Many parts in the northern mountains have rich reserves of minerals and fuels such as petroleum, coal, copper, lead, zinc, nickel, silver, tungsten, limestone, etc. Religious center. The Himalayan mountain ranges have always been considered as the abode of gods and saints. Large numerous cherries have developed in the in these mountains. Some of them are Amarnath, Vaishnava Devi, Badrinath, Kedarnath, Jwalaji, Gangotri, Yamunotri, Uttarakhand. So these are all the important religious centers in northern parts of India. So the major Indian Himalayan regions are Jammu Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, Sikkim are the important Himalayan regions. So now next you learn about Jammu and Kashmir. What is the importance of Jammu and Kashmir? Jammu and Kashmir are really three regions. The foothills plain of Jammu, the lakes and blue valleys of Kashmir rising the alpine passes, the high altitude plains and strikingly beautiful mountains on Ladakh, which lie behind these passes. It's enough to move one to poetry. Srinagar is Kashmir's summer capital and Jammu the winter capital. Jammu is the winter capital. Kashmir is the summer capital. Among the most attractive part of this India state has adventurous opportunities that can be segregated into the trekking, mountaineering and trans-Himalayas jeep safari. What can you make mountaineering expedition? The adventurous one of the would never be forget. It is done to the glaciers that are still curving to be explored. Himalayan ranges offer some of the most rigorous mountaineering challenges one can ever come across. The glaciers of Ladakh and Kashmir regions can test one survival, the fittest and most testing of them all, the Sichuan Glacier, known as largest glacier outside the polar region. Next, Himachal. What is the climatic condition or geographical features of Himachal? Himachal is one of the land of snow. It is a lofty peaks, cascading streams, alpine meadows and lush fruits laden valleys. Many parts of the Himachal state have the distinctly Austrian look with confined clad and chalet like huts with overgazing the balconies and severe blue valleys watered by snow fed streams. Simla, the capital of Himachal Pradesh, it's still very much a Raj township in appearance and atmosphere. Himachal also store numerous wonderful hill stations, which are particularly cool in summer. Simla, Dalhousie, Kulu, Manali and Kufri are the few of the hill stations in Himachal Pradesh, which offer breathtaking sceneries and countless options of adventurous sports. The Dharamshala, where Dalai Lama lives, is another important center of the tourist map. Understood? So next, Uttarakhand. Lying in the north of vast and bountiful expanse of India and cradled in the someone beauty and calm scenery and safety, stately Himalayas, Uttarakhand is a Devbhoomi that has attracted the tourists and pilgrims from the world over since of immemorial, comprising the 8 hill districts, an area of population that equal to state of Himachal Pradesh. Uttarakhand is a expression of divinity, austerity, meditation, penance and attainment. Uttarakhand is the paradise of the adventurous spot. The sheer variety ranging from the mountaineering, trekking, skiing, skating, water sports of the aero sports like hang gliding. So these are all the attractive destinations of the adventurous spots. So next, Sikkim. It is also Sikkim. It is also one of the 22 states of India. It is rooted the Himalayan massive like. It is also very important place, state. It is the smallest state of one of the smallest state in India. It bounded by the Nepal to the west and Bhutan to the east. Tibet Autonomous Region of the China to the north and northeast, and the West Bengal to the south, surrounded in a heavy moist. Guardian deity Kanchenjunga both protect terrify inhabitants. So Himalayan giant, world third highest peak, 8590. This itself means house of five treasures, represented by five soaring summits. Understood? So these and you will learn these also. The northeastern states region has so much to see, you must experience to so much write about the, it would take the volumes. The region of the northeastern India will get appreciated travelers, tourists and anthropologists and observers. It is impossible to describe the natures of that make this area unique, challenging and interesting. Go any one places and result will be that you will return for more. Seven states comprises of Assam, Arunachal Pradesh, Nagaland, Manipur, Tripura, Meghalaya, Mizoram, which are the seven sisters, are unique in their one way. The major Himalayan destination over here is Arunachal Pradesh. The state provides the abundant scope of angling, boating, rafting, trekking and hiking. Besides there are number of wildlife sanctuaries and national parks here, and animals, birds and plants will fascinating the visitors. So these are all the things we learn in this lesson. Once again you recall, the main occupation of the people in mountain is farming. There is a hills and central and south India. Himachal Pradesh is the land of snow. Uttarakhand is paradise of adventurous sports. Himalaya are source of all the great rivers. Understood? So in this lesson we learn about the climatic condition of the northern mountain region and what are the occupation of the people, how did the people live in this area, what are their clothes, what type of clothes they wear, and also which are the important rivers and hill stations, and what type of herbs they use, and also about agriculture. They also store of minerals. These are all the things, and also we learn about the religion, which are the important religious centers in this area. So these are all the things we learn in this lesson. Understood? So that is the life of northern mountainous region. So in next class I will continue. Till now, take care. Goodbye. Thank you.